Hello my dear students, welcome to computer science class. In our previous video we have started with the chapter that is the data types, and we have seen how the variable is been declared, initialized, and we have also seen how the data types are been classified. Mainly the data types are been classified into three types, that is the fundamental data types, derived data types, and the user defined data types. So the fundamental data types are nothing but they are the simple data types which can include float, char, double and void, whereas in case of derived data types, so these derived data types are again constructed using the simple data types only, but they were further actually classified into based upon the linear and the non-linear data structure. So the linear data structures are the ones where the elements are sequentially arranged, are said to be as linear data structures, wherein the examples for them were arrays, structures, unions, okay, pointers, linked list. Whereas the non-linear data structure, where the data elements are arranged in non-sequential manner, wherein the example was includes like graphs and the trees. And we have also seen what is user-defined data type. User-defined data types are being constructed using the fundamental data types only, but depending upon the needs and the requirements of the user. So we had the examples for the user-defined data types, you know, like structures, union, class, and enumerated. So in this video, let us see the further classification of fundamental data types. So students, this is a very important question from your exam point of view. Explain the fundamental data types. The first fundamental data types that we are going to discuss is about the int, that is integer data type. So in case of integer data types, so we shall see here the int. Actually, this is a keyword what we are using. As I said all the time, integers are the one which represents the whole number without any fractional part. For example, 10, minus 20, 0, whereas integer includes both the positive and the negative values, and the integer range always comes from minus 32,768 to plus 32,767. This is the range wherein it is supporting to have the value between the negative to the positive value, and usually this integer data type takes the 2 bytes of memory space. Okay, and what all operations you can perform on these integer data type? You can perform addition, you can perform subtraction, multiplication, division, right? So modulus operation, all these operations you can perform based in the integer data type. Example, how to define, okay, the integer data type is int. This is data type followed by the variable name. So this statements tell me that the variable a is a data type. It is a variable is a wherein it can hold the data type as integer that would represents the whole number. So this is one wherein I can declare here a single variable. Now this is the example where you can declare three variables of a type integer, but they should be separated by the comma, and all the statements in C++ should end with the semicolon. So this is the example for the integer data type. Moving on to the next one. So these all basic things you know, right? In our previous video I have shown this one. So here let us move to the next one, that is the character data type. So character data type, it allows you to store any character from the basic character set. So what do you mean by basic character set? The basic character is the one which contains the valid characters where the programming language can understand. It would include the alphabets like uppercase and the lowercase, right? So the examples for the character data type is the one which has been variable which has been enclosed, character which has been enclosed in a single quotes like a, y, 5, ampersand. So character data type in the sense always they actually represent some integer numbers, right? That is ASCII numbers. All these character, okay, all these characters are being associated with the integer numbers where the compiler convert to the equivalent ASCII codes. What does this ASCII actually stands for? American Standard Code for Information Interchange. Why these codes are being used? okay. So there were the different, you know, computer, different manufacturers were there. So they had their own kind of mapping. Like for example, whatever the code, whatever the sentence or the statements are being entered by the keyword, their interpretation was being different from, for example, Dell laptop has its own interpretation. Lenovo had it their own interpretation. So in that case, the computer were unable to communicate with each other because their mapping, their interpretation was entirely different. Then the ASCII code came into in existence, wherein they made some standard codes. Okay, they made some standard, they gave some standard codes to all the manufacturers of the computers, wherein the different kinds of computer can understand their language. So that is nothing but the ASCII code. So whatever the user is entering through the keyboard, okay, everything is been converted to the ASCII code. That is a common format the computer uses to understand what the user is entering through the keyboard. So almost how many characters codes we are having? Almost 256 characters we can have the ASCII codes, which includes the digits, alphabets and special characters. In the introduction to C++, when I have shown how the ASCII codes are being given to the 256 characters. Okay, then how many bytes this character data type can include? It includes 1 byte of memory space. 1 byte of memory space means it is 8 bits. Now here is an example here. So if I want to declare a character data type, okay, then for this is a data type followed by the variable name. Alpha is a variable name. I can say this as an identifier, wherein it is holding a character known as A, correct? So what is the ASCII? When this has been given as an input, now how the memory, how the compiler will understand this? It compiler will convert this character data type to the integer number. So because A is the one, small a is representing with the ASCII code as 97, B is representing with the 98. Similarly, capital A if I had given, it takes the ASCII value that is 65, and capital B if I take, it takes the value as 66. Then what are the operations we can perform on this character data type, that is input and output? In our previous example, introduction to C++ chapter, there we have seen the character functions, right? Is alpha, right? Is alphanumeric, is lower, is upper, correct? So all these we have seen, wherein we are using the character data type, what operations I can perform, that is input and output. So some of the programs I have shown, like how to give the single input, single character as an input, and how to get the single character as an output. So I cannot perform any kind of mathematical functions. But whatever the mathematical functions also, if it is performing, it will consider the ASCII value. Suppose if I give here as, if I want to add the two character data types as A and B, the value of A will be, here the character constant A will be converted to its ASCII value, B will be converted to its ASCII value number, that is 90, smaller A and smaller B is 97 and 98. So 97 plus 98, what answer I'll be getting? That exactly I'll get. So therefore, usually what kind of operations you can perform on the character data type is only on the input and output. Okay, I hope this character data type is clear here. So only you should remember is, how do I define the character data type, or how do I declare a character data type? By specifying the data type followed by the variable, and then specify the character variable here, and which should be enclosed in the single quotes. Moving on to the next data type, that is the float data type. As we all know that float is a kind of a data type where we are representing the real numbers, that is the numbers with the fractional part or the numbers with the exponential form also you can represent. So it includes the numbers, for example, 10.5, 45.0, right, minus 5.75, right, wherein it can supporting for both the positive as well as the negative numbers. So the range of the what we can store is minus 3.4 e raised to minus 38 to plus 3.4, that is exponential form, into 10 raised to 38. So where e actually represents the exponential notation. Students, all these we have already studied, and I have shown the chart also. So that's why I'm just having a revision of this. Already we know what is the size of the floating data type. So usually the size of floating data type is 4 bytes. okay, if it's a 4 bytes, that is 32, okay. So here 32 bits. So the what are the possible operations you can perform on this floating point? It is addition, subtraction, multiplication and division. One example, like how to declare and how to initialize the value for the floating data type is specify the data type, specify the variable name, use an assignment operator and then followed by the value. Remember, only for the character data type we have to provide the single quotes. Whenever if it is an integer or whenever it is a floating point or even whenever we are having the double as a data type, you need not to give any single quotes. And why do I give the single quotes also? Because the character data type always represents with the ASCII codes. That is the reason we should enclose them in the single quotes here. Okay. I hope you are able to follow. Moving on to the next data type, that is the double data type. So double data type is nothing but it is same as the floating data type, only with the double the precision. Usually the floating data type provides you the precision up to 7, after the decimal point up to 7 digits you can see, whereas in case of the double up to 14 or 15, after the decimal point up to 14 or 15 decimal numbers you can see. So definitely their precision will be hi, okay. Therefore, the size of the double data type is also about 8 bytes. Okay, the size is 8 bytes. Again, what all the operations you can perform on the double data type? You can perform addition, subtraction, multiplication, and division. And the range would be -1.7 e raised to, that is 10 e raised to, in the sense what? 10 raised to 3 minus 308 to 1.7 into 10 raised to plus 308. Okay, so example is specify the data type, that is double, specify the variable name is equal to assignment operator 5.5 e raised to minus 7, the representation is what? That is 5.5 into 10 raised to minus 7. That's what I said here. Minus 1.7 into 10 raised to minus 308 to plus 1.7 into 10 raised to 308. Now this range and everything, I will show it in with one of the chart I'll show here. But I hope you are able to understand how to declare the with the variables with a different data type. These examples in examination, what is important to write is, okay, this is the point it is to be written, how many bytes they are taking, how many range, what operations you are performing, and quoting one example for each data type is a must. Okay, moving on to the very last data type of the fundamental data type is the void data type. So what is a void? This type of data type actually represents the empty set of values. Empty set of values, it is used as a return type for functions and they do not return any value. For example, void print. Okay, I think you know this. We have used this void get data, void print. So this void is on a data type representing that the function print is not returning any value. Okay, so as in when we discuss with the programming concept, I'll definitely explain how we are using the void data type. Even in our doubt clarification session also, I'll just explain the void data type. So just you need to remember here, it is representing the empty sets. Empty set means it is not having any arguments or the parameters. And this, by looking at this void only, we can make out that it is not returning, this function is not returning any type of return value. Okay, so that is what is the void data type. So this is a example how to represent as a void data type. So this completes the fundamental data types, you know, answer. So usually they'll be asking a question, explain the fundamental data types. You need to write all these five with all the points, and quoting an example for each data type is a must. Okay, students, moving on to the next topic, that is modifiers. We already know what are the modifiers. So here we have the, see, the different data types. Integer, 2 bytes. 2 bytes means what? 16 bits, right? 1 byte is equal to 8 bits. Character, 1 byte. Float, 4 bytes. Double, 8 bytes. The range you can see here, minus 32 to plus 32,000. Okay, 1 minus 128 to 120 plus 127. Total when you add, it will be positive. If you take, it is the 256 characters we can give for the ASCII values 256, which includes the alphabets, okay, uppercase and lowercase digits as well as special characters. We are given the ASCII values. Then examples are these. Then we have the floating point also, whose range is 3.4 into 10 raised to minus 38 to 10 raised to 38 minus 1. Okay. Then we have the double. So minus 10 raised to 308. That's what I was telling. So this is the range. It's a very huge range, right? So I'll show you here this table. You can see. Okay. You see here double data type. 15 digits precision we are having. After the decimal point up to 15 digits we can see the number. And here how many? 7 digits we are having, right? So all these are the different data types. Plus we have to study about the modifiers. So what are the modifiers? As we said, discussed earlier, modifiers are the one which can alter the meaning of the basic data type that fits the needs of the various situations of the user. Okay, modifier is the one which is altering the meaning of the basic data type so that it fits the needs of the various situation of the user. Suppose for an example, if I want to declare integer a is equal to 40,000, if I want to give int a is equal to 40,000, is it possible? It's not possible, because the basic integer is providing the range between minus 32,000 to plus 32,000. I cannot exceed this range. But what if I want to give the value as 40,000? In that case, by using the modifiers, that is what kind of modifiers? Unsigned. If I use the unsigned modifier, I can give the value as 40,000. I can initialize that 40,000 to a variable known as a, because unsigned is a modifier which is helping me to alter the size, alter the basic size of this particular data type known as integer, wherein it is providing me the range from 0 to 65,000. So when I write it as unsigned int a is equal to 40,000, then the compiler will not give an error. If I just write as int a is equal to 40,000, definitely the compiler will give an error, because it is the out of the range. That is why the definition of modifier is nothing but it is used to alter the meaning of the base data type. That is, basic data type are what? Int, char, float, okay, double. These are the basic data types. So for all these basic data types, like for integer, okay, for the long, okay, for the float, for the double, for the character, we can apply the modifiers. And how many are the modifiers? There are four different types of modifiers. The first one is signed, unsigned, long, and then short. Okay, unsigned and signed we already know, right? Signed in the sense which represents the number both in terms of positive as well as in negative. Unsigned in the sense what? Which represents the numbers only in terms of positive. Long is the one modifier that provides you the higher precision. It provides you the more precision. Short is the very basic type. Short is a very smallest, you know, integer data which is not at all bigger than the simple integer. Now look at this chart here, the previous chart. We have four modifiers, I said. The first very, the smallest short, that is the modifier, is the short int. This is a short int. Short int is nothing but it means that it is an integer data type, but it is not bigger than the this data type. It is not bigger than the basic fundamental data type, that is integer. But the size and the range remains the same. That is why in case of the conversion, that is implicit conversion, we had taken one example. Short a is equal to 2000, int b we have taken, and we have moved the short int to the simple integer. We had moved the value, whatever is there in the a value, that is 2000, was being moved into the variable known as b, which is of data type was integer, whereas the a data type was short int. That means what I'm trying to say is the short int is not bigger than the basic int. Understood? So in some systems what happens, okay, the short int will be provided with the same amount of the space whatever the basic integer it has been providing. Okay, One more example I can take here is as the long int. Now, this integer is a with the same bytes and the same range. Unsigned int, 2 bytes, but the range changes here because it is representing all the positive numbers. Signed represents both the negative as well as positive. Now, coming to the what about the long integer? What it does says long integer, again it actually refers to the integer, that is the whole numbers only, but it is bigger than the basic integer size, wherein the long integer is providing how many bytes? 4 bytes it is providing, and the range, you look, it is providing a very high, you know, range. That is why we can say the long int means it is an integer data type only, but it is bigger than the simple or the basic integer. Similarly, short int, what I am trying to say is short int represent the integer value only, but it is not as big as this basic integer. I hope you are able to understand. But here what happens, short int, the size and the range remains the same, but in case of long int, the size as well in terms of bytes as well as range, it is actually double the size of the basic one. Okay, I hope you are able to understand. Now, here in case of modifiers, what happens is, to what all the data types we can apply the modifiers, let us see that. See, the modifier signed, unsigned and long and short can be applied to the integer data type. Just now I have shown this, right? I can apply unsigned, signed, short and long. I can apply to the basic integer data type. Similarly, for the character, I can apply only unsigned and signed. For the character data type, I can apply only unsigned and signed. I cannot apply long modifier to the character data type. Only I can even not apply the short also. I can apply only short, I can apply there. Only signed and unsigned I can apply to the character. Then we can apply the long modifier to the double data type. Look at here. We can apply the long modifier to the double. Actually, the double data type size is what? 8 bytes and this is the range. But when we apply for the long data type, look in the size. It is actually increasing. It is increasing up to 10 bytes. Okay. It is increasing up to 10 bytes. So, therefore, we can apply the signed, unsigned, long and short to the integer basic data type, wherein what exactly these modifiers are doing? They are helping to change or alter the size of the basic data type as per the user's needs and requirements. And we can apply only unsigned and signed modifier to the character data type, and we can apply the long modifier to the double data type. Now let us see some of the example how to use these modifiers. Now look at here, unsigned A in the sense what? C++ actually it is even supporting for the shorthand notation. In introduction to C++, we have already studied the shorthand notation, shorthand assignment operator, shorthand addition operator, right? So if we do not specify any of the data type here, then it is implicitly understood that is integer data type is there. Okay, it is implied that already the integer. So unsigned int A is similar that only unsigned A also I can refer. I hope you are able to understand. Now actually this and this are the same, only the variable are the different. I can specify integer here or I may not. If I don't specify the data type as integer, means it is implied, that implied in the sense what? It is assumed that already an integer data type it is. Similarly here you can see I didn't specify the integer. Actually I should have written unsigned int value is equal to 328. If I don't write, it is understood that it is a integer. Unsigned int value is equal to 328. Like this I can use. Okay. Then what? I can even apply the long data type to the integer, I said, right? Unsigned long value is equal to look at this value. It's a very huge 0776745, but this is out of the range of basic integer data type, isn't it? Because of using of the modifiers unsigned. Unsigned represents what? It should be only the positive number. And long, what it represents? It should have a very, you know, it supports for how many data types? It supports for the 8 data type, isn't it? So that is why I can give a very bigger number in case of the integer data type, rather than it's exceeding even it's the basic range, which is from -32,000 to +32,000. So this is all possible only because of using these modifiers, that is unsigned, signed, short and long. In the examination, they will ask you what is modifier and mention its type. So in that case, you just need to write this definition and mention. Sometimes they may ask you what is modifier and give an example for the modifier. In that case, any of these example you can quote, it will be considered. I hope students, modifiers concept is clear. Moving on to the very last topic of this chapter, that is enumerated data type. Enumerated data type is an example for what? User defined data type. Okay, so what do you mean by user defined data type? User defined data type is been constructed by using the basic fundamental data types only, but it fulfills the needs and the requirements of the user. Now let us see how to use that enumerated as one of the data type. It's an user defined type consisting of a set of named constants like an enumerator. So usually to indicate the integer, floating or double data type, we are using the keywords like int, float, double, void, right? Similarly, if I have to declare any variable of enumerated data type, we are using the keyword known as enum. So when I use the keyword known as enum, it start assigning the value automatically, like 0, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, automatically it will assign. How it will, I'll tell you. So any data, any variable, if we have declared it as an, see here for an example, enum is a data type followed by a variable name, or we can refer here as a tag. Okay, we can refer this as a tag, or we can even refer it as a variable name. Followed by that, we are specifying the, these are nothing but symbolic constant, very bad, comma bad, satisfactory, comma good, comma very good, comma excellent. All these are nothing but the symbolic constant. So this enum is a keyword that helps you to create the enumerators, wherein we are assigning automatically, it is assigning the symbolic constant. How it is automatically assigning the symbolic constant? Now very bad, this is in one of the enumerator which is holding a symbolic constant, that is 0. Bad is a, you know, enumerator that is holding a value, that is 1. Satisfactory is a enumerator, it is holding the value as 2. Similarly, good, 3 it will hold, very good, 4, excellent, it will hold the value as 5. You need not to, you know, explicitly mention. Automatically, whenever I'm using the keyword as an enum, it will assign the symbolic constant to all these enumerators. Now let us see the syntax. I'll show you the example how it will automatically assign. Okay, here the syntax is how to declare the enumerated variable. Enum is a keyword followed by the tag or followed by the variable name. Okay, then followed by the enum list. Enum list are these. These are called as enumerators. See, for the definition of enumerated data type, this is the syntax. How do I declare a variable? How do I declare a variable? For this particular enumerated data type choice, I am creating a variable known as my choice. That is how I am declaring enum. Tag declarator. That means for this choice, what I am declaring, I am giving a shortcut name as my choice. See here, for declaration of a variable of type tag. Just in simple, you should understand enumeration is nothing but it is one of the user defined data type that consists of a, these are the named constants called as an enumerators. Okay, now these named constant, what they will do? They will help you to create the symbolic constants. What are these symbolic constants? These are the values which will be automatically assigned to each of this particular enumerators. Okay, now examples I'll show you. I'll create an enumerated data type with a tag name as my enum. Enum tag name followed by the alpha, beta, gamma. Now these are what? Enumerators. Internally, compiler will assign the symbolic constants to them, wherein alpha takes the value as 0, beta takes the value as 1, gamma takes the value as 2. I need not to mention, as one this statement, automatically the value for alpha will be created, value for the beta will be created, value for the gamma will be created by the compiler itself. That is what is symbolic constant. Now I don't want alpha to take the value as 0. I don't want beta to take the value as 1. Neither I want the gamma to take the value as 2. I can explicitly give, even I can provide the explicit value like enum. Okay, I can write like enum, my enum, okay, flower bracket, alpha is equal to 200, comma, beta is equal to 300, gamma is equal to 500, close the flower bracket and semicolon. One thing is, implicitly compiler only will assign. If you doesn't want the implicit values, by default always they start with a 0 and 1, 2, 3. If I don't want those values to have, then I can even explicitly provide those values to the alpha, beta and gamma. Similarly, this one, another example we have, enum foot size. Enum foot size, okay, followed by the enum list. Small, I am explicitly giving the value as 10, medium as 100, large as 1000. If I have not given, compiler itself will assign the implicit. Implicit means what? Automatically, if it will assign, if we don't provide an explicit values. Explicit values means what? The whatever the user wants to give the values, that is nothing but the explicit values. So this is enum. Enum enumerated data type. Moving on to the last concept, that is C++ enum type conversion. I can convert the enumerated data type to the integer data type. I can convert, but I cannot convert the enumerated data type back to the integer. Now here is an example. There is an implicit conversion from enum to the enum type data type to the integer data type. What I am trying to do this? This is type conversion, or I can even call it as type casting. What do you mean by type casting? We have seen implicit conversion and explicit conversion in introduction to C++. What? So type casting is nothing but changing the data type from one data, changing the value data type of variable of one data type to the another data type I am trying to change. Now here is an example. Enum, my enum, in this alpha comma beta comma gamma, we know that this is an enumerated data type and my tag name name is my enum. Alpha, implicitly compiler will assign, what value will be assigned to the alpha? 0. Beta will be assigned with value as 1. Gamma has been assigned to the value as 2 here. If we explicitly mention, then you can mention here by equals to assignment operator, and then you can mention the values. Now what I am trying to do is, I am moving the enumerated data type value to the integer data type. What I am doing? Beta is equals to I, and I am telling that I is of data type was integer. What is the beta value it is consisting of? It is consisting the value as 1, right? Internally it is consisting, it will not show. So the value 1 is will be moved into a variable known as I. It has been moved, therefore the value of I is 1. Now what is in case of gamma? How we can use it in programming concept, you see. Gamma plus 3 I am adding. So what is the internal value of gamma? Gamma value is actually 2, right? So I am doing the addition here. So gamma will be replaced with the value here, 3 plus 2. And that value I am moving into a variable called as j, which is of data type as integer. I hope you are able to understand. I am trying to convert from one data type to the another data type. That is nothing but type conversion. And here I am trying to convert what? That is enum data type to the integer data type I am converting. But vice versa is not possible. Why vice versa is not possible? Look at here. Okay, so on the other hand, C++ doesn't support for the implicit conversion from int to the enum type. So following are illegal. What I'm trying to do, the value 2, I'm trying to move in a x where my enum type, okay, that where is my, this is enum, the tag name is type and the variable is x. But do you know what the x value is already been assigned by the compiler internally? He doesn't know. So I cannot, one thing is I can explicitly give the value like this, I can explicitly give the value like this, but I cannot give explicit value like this. Whatever the integer value, I cannot assign it to the one of the enumerator variable. Similarly, 123, I cannot apply this value to the one of the enumerator called as y, because already internally the compiler have already provided the symbolic constant to the enumerator x, and already the compiler has given the value for this particular enumerator for the y. So I cannot move the new value of integer to the enumerator x and 123 value to the y. Therefore the compiler will give an error, so it will not be allowed by the compiler. So those, therefore these two, you know, statements are to be considered as illegal. Only we can convert from the enumerated data type to the integer, but we cannot convert from integer to the enumerator, because already enumerated data type, enumerators are already having a implicit value which has been assigned by the compiler. So students, this completes your chapter, that is data types. From this chapter, what questions you may expect is, what is variable? Give the syntax of declaring and initializing a variable with an example. This one definite question you can expect. If at all, if you are expecting the 5 marks question, definitely they will give and explain briefly the fundamental data types. In that, you have to explain each and every point with those 5 data types, int, char, float, double and void, and example is a must there. And then finally, they may ask one more question. What is modifier? Mention the modifiers, they may ask. Or they may also ask, what is modifier? Give an example for modifiers. In that way, they may ask. And lastly, they may ask the question on enumerator. What is enumerated data type? 1 marks question, and give an example. So you can give this, what is enumerated data type? You can give this, definition you can give. And then give an example like this. Enum, choice, very bad, bad, satisfactory. This way also you can give example, or you can even give this example, or this way also you can give an example. So this completes the chapter, that is data type. Thank you students, keep watching the video, solve the assignment.